take the struggle that they put us through with the strength to fight the power like Chuck D a do with the insight to be equal. No, the sky needed a voice that finds reason to multiply people in the streets for the cause. Marching on Washington miners, we'll be walking through walls. Type of superhero show up when ain't no one to call. Better shield you from them shields that been killing us all. High beams for eyes to peek the villains in the dark. Power of resolution for a war with even start. The knowledge to build and grow where they live and take care of the kids and the older folk. The queen cause they need it most. Politics with the king. About economic growth. Cure PTSD. Cause mental health ain't a joke. Feed the hungry and dope. Everyone would know. Everywhere we go.
Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Be the black superhero.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Today, it's week four, and we've got what should be a great one here between the Washington Commanders and the Dallas Cowboys. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Dak going to start out going to the air. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And he'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. An early statement on the game's first play. 18 yards and a first down. Carries this one past the midfield stripe and into Commander territory. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. The Cowboys had 0-3 here to begin the campaign, and you hate to have to say it this early in the season, but getting close to must-win time, is it not?
And I totally understand why you expressed it that way, because it's so early in the season, it feels like hyperbole. But I think you are spot on this one. Yes, there's still time to turn things around, but they've got to start to win right now if they have any hopes of trying to make the playoffs.
The first carry now for Tony Pollard. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Swinging this out for Pollard. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
From the red zone now, Prescott. Pollard here once again, back-to-back catches. Touchdown! Tony Pollard, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point by Moore, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Kick this one away, and off it goes. That'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. First and 10 here for Hal and the Commanders at their 25-yard line. Hal throwing on first down here. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time. Separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Second down throw for Howell. That's going to be caught downfield by McLaurin. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. It's a first down Washington on a pickup of 18.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On first down, Howell. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. With that grab, he now sits at 200 for his career, and maybe more importantly, a first down. They'll throw on first down. Here's Howell. Got this complete to Jahan Dotson. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. Usually see those guys out wide get called for holding on running plays. Here, a passing play.
Yeah, sometimes when you get this quick screen, bubble screen, anything where they're having to block for their fellow receiver, usually at the point of attack, and this time he got caught.
Howell from the gun. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A well-executed 22-yard gain. First down, Howell to throw. And this is incomplete. Oh, he had 6 points right in his hands, but could not hang on.
They're such a talented team at defending the perimeter and taking away throws to the outside. Great confidence, great skill.
From the 21, it's second and 10. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Side is going to be caught by Samuel. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. Well, this is what you want to see from your rookie quarterback on an opening drive, Charles. He looks cool. He looks calm. He looks collected in marching them down the field.
And, Brandon, I just think the game continues to change and evolve because we're calling these guys rookies. But, you know, they've thrown the football so much at a younger level now, way more so than what we saw when guys came into the league when you and I came through.
And also just the way in particular to him, Charles, how he handles himself in meetings, just so professional, mature. It looks like he's been in the league 5 years.
Yeah, he cares about the game. He cares about his performance, and it's showing.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. They'll run with Gibson, and he will take it in. Touchdown, Commanders. Antonio Gibson. His second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Commanders respond to that opening drive touchdown with one of their own. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fielded right around the 8. And able to get this out to the 25. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated, because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice. But at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
Prescott off play action. And that is incomplete.
We know he has a lot of confidence in his arm and likes to force it downfield, but the coverage was tight there. Fortunate it wasn't picked off.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Washington that scoops it up, and he is going to bring this one back to the house. It's a Commanders touchdown on the scoop and score.
Slide for the PAT. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter. So here's the kickoff now, as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. Bringing him down for a loss was Tariq Castro Fields with a really nice effort.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
Well, the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Through one corner, 14-7, our score. Throwing on second and 14. Prescott. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
Well, we've seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half. Unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball out of the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. So as they take it over, we step aside. Complete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Prescott. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete.
And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. But Dak Prescott, probably not the first name you think of in terms of strongest arms in the NFL, but he showed it off there.
Well, one way or the other, you knew they'd have to push the ball downfield on third and long. But I'm not sure the defense is expecting to push it that far downfield. Their math didn't add up, but it certainly did for the offense.
And that throw, pretty impressive, and even 61 yards through the air. The first down carry by Elliott. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Jet sweep as Prescott bats it forward. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with that, they're now out of timeouts and still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. Six DBs on the field for Washington on third down. Prescott to throw it. And the Washington pressure gets to him, and he will go down. Chase Young drops him for a loss of 10, and it's going to be fourth and long.
All fans of the Washington Commanders have been holding their collective breath to see how Chase Young returns from last season's torn ACL. If we see the 2020 Rookie of the Year back on the field, everyone who likes the garnet and gold will be awfully happy.
And this will be touchdown inside the 20. They'll spot it at the 18-yard line. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. out of the air on first and 10. This is caught by his tight end, Logan Thomas. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. And just a yard to go here on second down. Second down, Howell back to pass. This will be caught at Samuel. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 25-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Once more, Howell back to the air. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Straight ahead, Gibson. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. Seventh play of this drive coming up, and a long way to go on third down. Third and long, here's Howell. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Thomas. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
And that big game may just change the thought process here on fourth down. I think in the red zone, they might now consider going for it.
They'll go for it and run a little touch pass here. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that, but by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on fourth down. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Back to the ground with Gibson. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. DeMarcus Lawrence in on the tackle.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
This call down near the goal line, and he takes it in. Touchdown, Commanders. Terry McLaurin, a 3-yard touchdown run, and the Commanders have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and it's now 21-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Here's Prescott. Oh, and that'll be incomplete. Oh, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Here's Prescott. Flushed out right. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. He's going to pick up the first down and then some. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Prescott on first down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. So we have come upon halftime, and it's the visiting group from Washington who are out on top. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. We welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here.
So Washington in a good spot. They've got the lead. They will get the football as the second half gets underway.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They've reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
And they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football.
Pretty much everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is, you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
Open man downfield is land. It's complete.
And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line.
But they didn't ease into that drive right out of the turnover. They go for the big shot downfield and hit it. A lot of teams have that opportunity, but not every coach is going to green light that type of a play call. I love their aggressiveness.
Going anywhere. He'll lose a couple back to the six.
Second and goal from the six this time. Play fake. Here's Prescott. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line.
A loss of three on the sack made by multiple defenders.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
They'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal.
To throw is Prescott. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down. Brett Maher now for the Cowboy field goal. This is a 26-yard attempt. Maher able to put this one through. And that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game, and they make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The fireman. Go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
A give up the middle to Gibson.
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
Yeah, the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back.
Throwing on third down here.
And that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're standing a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Tressway now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're numb to pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But I also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And that'll bring up second down.
And let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up front his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
Throwing again on second down. Prescott, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Prescott now. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Benjamin St. Juice, and he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown. The extra point by Sly is up and good, and the lead is up to 18 now. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. It's Tariq Castro Fields who picked it, and the Commanders are going to take possession of the football. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Give them four on the carry there. It's second and goal. Al down to throw it. He's got it. Touchdown, Commanders. Antonio Gibson. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Commanders are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. The extra point by Sly is up and good. And they open the lead up now to 25. Kick team out there for the Commanders as they send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout.
This is caught inside the 15.
And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years, and the arm strength still there, and he showed it off on that one.
And that's a rare bright spot in what's overall been a pretty poor showing so far, but you got to figure when you're down a bunch, why not take some big shots? And they connect on that one.
First down throw for Prescott. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. Odell Beckham, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys get a bit closer. Extra point by Moore, and good. And that'll cut the lead down to 18. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
A out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
On second down, here's Gibson again. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now throwing on first down here. Slings this deep from McLaurin. It got his man complete. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Commanders get a third quarter.